Shortly after the passage of FAS 157, there was some research that found that level three assets were being discounted by equity market investors. So if a firm disclosed that they had $100 worth of a level three asset, the equity market was potentially treating that as if it was worth only $95 to protect them from the possibility that the investment wasn't actually worth $100. And so we came into this project thinking, if that's going on, if the equity markets are discounting these level three assets, then it might make sense for managers within these firms, if they understand that discounting, to think about their investment portfolio and potentially shift their investment portfolio or their investment allocation away from these level three assets towards the level one and level two assets that were not being discounted. And so we looked at how did public banks' investments in level three assets change from before the standard to after the standard relative to how private banks' investments in level three assets changed from before the standard to after the standard. And we found that the public banks decreased their investments of these level three assets much more significantly than private banks. And that finding gave us a lot more confidence to be able to say that it was actually the passage of 157 and these new disclosures that reduced the holdings of level three assets at these banks and not some other concurrent event like the financial crisis or something else that you might be able to think of. As an investor, if you're trying to value a firm, decide whether or not to make an investment in that firm, we think it might be important for you to be aware of the fact that as accounting rules and standards change over time, that may cause the firm to change their business decisions, change their investment strategies. That could ultimately change your valuation of the firm. Second, we think that it is very important for regulators and standard setters to be aware of this as they continue to push standards forward and think about how to improve the standard setting process. We think it's important for them to understand that changes in standards, even small changes in disclosure requirements, potentially will lead to changes in the behavior of managers within these firms that are subject to the standards. And finally, we think just kind of more personally as an accounting professor, as somebody who's kind of been interested, excited, involved in accounting my entire life, I think it's really cool to find some evidence that accounting actually matters, that changes, even small changes in accounting, have the potential to lead to changes in how business decisions are made.